Imagine your time sitting at a red light, reduced with traffic signals that are smarter than the ones we use today. That's the aim by a group of U of M researchers conducting a new study. Lou Ragus talked to them about it today.
How frustrating is it when the light turns green and just about every car in front of you makes it through before it turns red, except for you?
I would hope that it would improve in just in terms of getting people, more people through the intersection or getting them through the intersection faster.
Assistant Professor Michael Levin at the U of M and his team just finished the first phase of a study that, if successful, could make those traffic signals a lot smarter and a whole lot less frustrating.
It's a new way of approaching traffic signal timing.
How do most traffic signals currently work?
Some are on fixed times. There are also some signals that are adaptive or actuated, where they respond to people or the presence of vehicles.
The method Levin's team at the University of Minnesota's Center for Transportation Studies is testing is a combination of both. In phase one, they took traffic data from 7 Hennepin County intersections and used mathematical formulas in an attempt to improve the number of vehicles getting through each green light. The simulations using the research algorithm was successful.
We saw sometimes up to 50% reductions in delay.
Now they're using equipment in the lab to conduct safety tests to make sure the theories work with the hardware.
If MnDOT likes it, that would be on the roads using sensors, modifying the actual signal timings.
The Local Road Research Board funded the research in partnership with Hennepin County. The method is called max pressure control, and when put into practice, will involve sensors in the pavement that more accurately read the number of cars waiting and approaching the intersection. Levin says they are a year or two away from phase three, which involves testing the hardware at the Minnesota intersections.
If this study is successful, we hope to see in 5 to 10 years, maybe a wider or more widespread use, maybe having this deployed in more intersections and on a more permanent basis.
Right now, this concept does not allow for multiple intersections to communicate with each other, but that's something that they plan to study. Back to you.